Okay. Yeah.
Hey guys, what's up? We're here to talk about Christmas this time. I am Isaac, and that is Ryan. Wow, that's a long way across, but yeah, that's Ryan. And so yeah, how was your Christmas? So many children.
It was
loads of awesome children involved.
Yeah, lots of kids.
Kids.
Not that many kids. Christmas Day, I didn't have anybody here. It was just me.
Oh, that's perfect. You know, we had nothing here either. I was just here watching TV. It was really good. I'm a real Grinch when it comes to Christmas. I can't stand it because it's all everything's so advertised. It's all about sales and advertising and everything's commercial nowadays. It's not. Oh, Christmas.
Which makes me sad is the kids. It's like looking at the kids, it's like they don't even know. It's like so hard to ingrain in them that it's not about what they're getting and everything about that.
It really is. It's really
it's really hard because all they care about is that iPhone. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, your kid's at that age. My boy's at the age where he's like, I want a monster truck, and he got like a monster truck and fucking sand pit toys and books and all sorts of stuff. It was really funny though, because he's like unwrapping his presents and he's like, wow! And then he'd drop it on the ground and go and get us another present. Really the big thing.
Yeah, I know. They don't even care. You want to see a picture of my Christmas? Here's a nice picture.
The big thing for my boy was like, he was just enjoying opening shit that was for him. Best. Yeah,
there's a picture of my Christmas.
Best Christmas ever. Did you open those roses or did you go and buy them yourself, unwrapped?
I found them.
You found them?
At the site. They were already there.
You just picked them up off somebody else's grave, eh? That's how you work it.
Yeah.
Beauty.
Oh, I can't get it off now.
Oh, no. Sorry, he's kind of an old dude, too. It works.
Oh my god. How do I use a computer?
How do you what? How do you use a computer?
Computer camera.
How do I camera.
Computer?
How do I
computer? Okay, Google camera. Okay, Daryl.
Oh no, did I turn the fucking thumbnails off? I'm gonna have to preview which one I put up first. No, not that one.
What about after Christmas though? Those Boxing Day sales.
Yeah, man. Fucking heaps of them, eh?
I don't remember hearing anything crazy.
My girlfriend's gone and bought. Hang on, here we go. Here's a proper photo of my Christmas. Probably gonna be way too big. Yeah, it is. There's a photo of my Christmas, my little boy and stuff. Playing with the bubble machine. He loved the bubble machine. The best thing in the world. And my Missy's Hell TV corner.
Wow, did you know that there's a tally site for Black Friday deaths?
Wow, that's awesome.
I was looking for something related to Boxing Day and like there was nothing.
Well, see, in New Zealand,
Black Friday deathcount.com.
Black Friday isn't a big deal in New Zealand. It's a big deal.
Not in Canada either.
It's a big deal over like in America. I think America's the only place that really does massive Black Friday sales. Our biggest sale of the year is Boxing Day. For sure. Hey, there was a death.
I wouldn't even call it a sale thing.
There were no deaths this year. There was only one death last year in, where's that? San Antonio man helped a woman being beaten in a Walmart parking lot who was shot dead. Oh my god, that's ridiculous.
only
America would have a tally system for how many people die on a fucking shopping. 10 deaths and 100 and 111 injuries. That's more than a fucking 7.8 Richter earthquake in New Zealand killed. That's ridiculous. Mind you, that is over.
Greatest country on earth. It's the greatest country.
Greatest ever. That is
greatest.
That is over 10 years, but realistically, there should be zero. Just because it's Black Friday doesn't mean that you should shoot somebody.
No, the sale is going on anywhere, ever.
It's so insane.
That's nuts. The funniest thing
is they're still paying retail prices. They're not paying wholesale prices at all. They're just paying like slightly less marked up retail prices.
Oh, I know.
It's like 50% off.
But yeah. Actually, when you look at some of the sales, dude, when you actually look at some of the sales, it's actually out of this world. Like we don't understand it because we've never experienced it. But they have like TVs that are only like $1,200 for like $200.
Oh.
Like there's insane stuff like that goes on. So it's like out of our realm to understand it because we don't experience that kind of savings but, on a day, on like an, any day of the year. It doesn't matter what day of the year it is.
But at the same,
if you're living in New Zealand or you live in Canada, it doesn't matter if it's a sale or not. That shipping cost is now tripled because it's on sale.
Yeah, true. But at the same time, it's like it's not so much a sale as it is like a clearance for next generation product, especially when it comes to electrics. Next gen products are just getting pushed into the shelves, and so they're like, what are we gonna do with this TV? We can throw it in the dumpster, or we can put it on sale for like $200 and someone's gonna come and buy it.
Oh yeah. By no means you're not getting a brand new the brand new wallpaper TVs for dirt cheap.
No, absolutely.
Those nothing like that. Those but I mean good, like so. if your family normally has like a 36 inch flat screen TV, nothing fancy about it, and there's like a Samsung on sale for $300. Like maybe you would trample a black woman. Who knows? I don't know why she had to be black. I don't know why she had to be black.
Why is she black?
I just feel like that was inappropriate. I don't know. Whatever.
maybe you're black too. So hey.
I feel like it's a lot of black people.
If you've already got a 36 inch TV in 2017, you live so close to Detroit, you may as well be a black person. But if you've
like, can hear the sales.
If you've got a 36-inch TV, you're living in a pretty poor house. I'm sorry, this is 2017. Everyone's got a 42-inch, like, minimum, usually. Like, their lounge TV is going to be 40.
Maybe that's why I'm just going to get off that topic now.
Well, I mean, I've got a I had a 42 or 40. I can't remember what I had, and then one went on sale. It was a 55-inch was on sale for like $800. I was like, "Fuck yeah, I'm gonna go and buy that." Why wouldn't I? Now I have 15 more inches of screen. That's great.
Yeah, we have a 40-inch in the bedroom.
Yeah, exactly. Like that's your standard TV price is like 40-inch nowadays. Speaking of inches and screens, I am so sick of my three fucking Frankenstein screens. I really want to get like a nice three screen mount system, but I need another $1,500 for two more screens, which is probably a little bit overkill, but I want it. It's so bad. It's so overkill. I want four QHD screens, three QHD screens for no reason.
Yeah.
No particular reason.
Well, Christmas, not anymore. Never mind.
Mm. Christmas was good, though. Christmas was quiet for me. And we got what have we got? New Year's in like 2 days. Well, I've got New Year's in 2 days. You've got 3 days to wait, but... Oh, that'll be fun. Oh, shit.
You know what I do for New Year's? Go to bed real early.
Really?
Because I'm old.
You're old? You're just like, fuck it. I'm going to go to bed at 11 o'clock. No, my girlfriend's working.
Dude, it's 11:38 right now. It feels like it's like 4 o'clock in the morning for me. Like, I'm not doing okay.
Oh.
So I'm keeping off towers as we talk about Christmas and consumerism.
So you go to bed early, do you?
Oh, when I can sleep, yeah.
Hey, should I show you some New Zealand currency? Now that I've got some available? These are New Zealand currency notes. These are the big ones.
I should have had water with me, dude. My mouth is so dry.
There's the Queen of England. And on the back is some sort of native bird. I have no idea what it probably says right there. It's in a Maori language, so I can't pronounce that. Kariria. Some fucking bird. So that's... And it's not paper. It's like proper Canadian style... And so that's the old $20 bill. This is the new $20 bill. She looks like she's aged, like something fierce.
She looks like Yoda.
It's like, oh, Queen of England. Oh, she looks so young and so beautiful. And boom!
That is not a flattering photo. She does not look alive.
Well, still got the same bird on the back, I think. Yeah, it's still the same bird on the back there. I don't know why. That
okay, nice like. Picture of the bird, but like, what is going on with that portrait?
And then
she looks like Yoda.
This is the new $10 bill. I think this isn't the queen. This is... Wait, is this even the queen? No, this isn't the queen. This is some governor. No, that has to be the queen. That's the queen. This one we've got some sort of duck. It's called a whew.
Whew? Why are we talking about your money?
And the other side we've got Kate Shepard. I don't
know.
It
looks real Canadian, though. I'm not going to lie.
It does, eh? The new ones do. The new ones look ridiculous.
I have is hundreds on me, but look.
All I have is hundreds. All I have is money making it rain. Was it 100 yen?
No, look, literally, all I have is hundreds on me.
Some Monopoly monies, right?
It does look ridiculous, look.
Who the fuck is that old dude? Is it some old Canadian dude?
I don't know who the fuck that is.
Some old Canadian dude.
Sir Robert L. Borden. Prime Minister.
You know, we put Rutherford on one of our fucking bills.
Like we got like a DNA strain back there and shit.
Oh wow, that's flash. It's fancy. Have you heard of Ernest Rutherford?
No.
Okay, well, if you look at one of our bills, I can't remember which one it is. This one is Edmund Hillary, the guy who climbed the Olympic, the fucking mountain of. I can't even. What the fuck is the mountain? What's the big ass mountain called? I can't even think of the name of it right now.
What does this have to do with Christmas?
It's nothing to do with Christmas. We're not talking about Christmas anymore. We're talking about money. No, we're not. We're talking about Ernest Rutherford. You know Ernest Rutherford? I think he's on our $100 bills. Do you know what he did?
No fucking idea what you're talking about.
Do you know? You don't know who Ernest Rutherford is?
No.
Okay, he was the first person to split the atom. And he's a New Zealander. So we put him on, I think he's either on our 50s or our $100 bills, one of the two, because he's obviously not in a 5, 10, or a 20. So he's on one of those, he's either on 50 or 100. It's like, so we're going to put the guy who like invented the nuclear bomb on one of our currencies. That's a brilliant idea. Americans are going to love it. Yeah, guy.
You're just off on a tangent about money right now.
I'm not talking about money. I'm talking about Ernest Rutherford, the guy who invented the fucking A-bomb, basically. Like, the reason behind problems in the world wars, anyway. I guess like, they probably solved a lot of problems more than they caused problems. Except for now when people go, oh, I'm from Japan and I hate Americans because they blew my fucking town up with my grandparents in it.
Yeah, remember?
I remember.
Remember when that happened? Oh, fuck.
You getting tired? We can stop.
I'm exhausted. No, we're going now, but we gotta stay on topic. I'm just so out of it. I'm just letting you go off on your tangents here.
We don't have a topic. I'm making topics up as we go along.
There you go.
We could talk about
my topic. I've been looking into archaeology stuff lately. A lot of archaeology stuff. Oh, yeah. Dude, it's weird. It's weird shit.
Like, we talking like ancient aliens archaeology, or we talking like real archaeology?
I'm talking like ancient aliens archaeology, looking into it beyond like what like they show you on TV and stuff. Dude, there's some crazy ass shit out there.
There is some weird ass shit,
like the pyramids and stuff, like the way they made them, like the way they're so like perfectly fitting, like two sheets of paper. It's impossible to do that with like a hand and chisel. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and the way that they the speed in which they built it is just incredible.
Not even that, just the blocks fitting together where you can't even fit a hair in between them.
Oh wow, is it that tight?
Yeah, with a hand chisel.
So it's so perfectly sculpted that it's like.
It's like dead, like what we would do with today's technology. They're saying like if, to do that with those size blocks, it would need to be like 6 feet in diameter or something, which we can't do. We can't make saws that big.
So with the technology we have nowadays, we couldn't rebuild the pyramids.
That's what they say. We couldn't rebuild that.
Well,
yeah.
I mean, there is that theory that there was like another being or like a race from the future or some shit that came and fucking help them build.
I swear to God, as crazy as it sounds, it makes sense that we got to a point where we left. Do you know what I mean? Because there's all these cultures all around the world and everything that all depict angels or beings leaving and saying they're going to come back at some point.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They all have the same sort of mythology.
So you say,
and then the same thing with like the story, like the biblical stories about giant floods and how those are all over the world as well.
Yeah,
the same sort of stories about a person who has like knowledge of an unforeseen event happening in the floods. Now think about if you were living in New Orleans or Florida in the last little while when the hurricanes and stuff came through and that was a flood. Imagine that back in like hundreds of thousands of years ago.
We had a mud house.
That would be a flood of biblical proportions. You know what I mean? Not now because you've got 5 billion people living in the world. But 7 billion. Whatever the fuck it is.
Yeah.
strong, and just a huge amount of people everywhere. So an event that big isn't of biblical proportions anymore. Do you know what I mean?
And on top of that, we've got buildings that way overcome the size of the storms and shit nowadays. So we can easily.
But the thing is they're not even earthquake proof and stuff. Like they have these monolithic sites all over the earth where these giant blocks are so precisionly cut, like laser cut. It looks like.
Yeah.
Like they got modern equipment with lasers, and to do it nowadays, it would be like impossible. Basically impossible, they're saying, because the deeper they dig down in a lot of these sites, they'll notice the same architecture, but then they dig down even deeper, and there's bigger blocks underneath there. So the people like the Mayans and the Inca and the Egyptians and stuff found these places and started building on top of them.
Oh, wow.
You know what I'm saying? How, like, we sort of build on top of things now?
Yeah, so you're saying that the stuff that they built on top of was outdated, like was a precursor before they were there. Even and they found them, they're like, wow, these are really good structures, we may as well build on top of them.
Yeah, and they had it, and you can see that like the newer stuff gets worse.
Well, if you think about it, on top of that, Socrates wasn't even around then, there was no concept of mathematics or anything back then. There was none of that, there was no measuring. There would have been measuring, but it wouldn't
no,
have
exactly. Been. There was no measuring, but
there was no units of measurements
based on the units of like pi and the golden number and all these different architectural equations. The pyramid fits all these equations perfectly. It's a lot of stuff to get into. I'm not really explaining it properly, but like there's lots of crazy shit that like looks like, and it makes total sense that we got to a point where we left, and that's why they can't find things like tools or clothes or furniture or anything really. Like,
so
they find little things here and there, but they don't really find full tools or full things. You know what I mean?
So theoretically, what do you think's happened? Do you think that we've gotten to an advanced technological state where we've gone back in time to help ourselves, to like help ourselves evolve? Or do you think that we've always been able to do that and that we're just in a period where we can't do it anymore? Or what do you reckon? You reckon it's from more ancient times when we were more civilized or more advanced, and then there was a massive catastrophic event that wiped us all out and we had to leave?
I think the catastrophic event would have been the global warming back then, which would have been the end of the ice age.
Or do you think
which would cause those floods and everything to happen, which means like we're looking in the wrong spots, which makes sense. We're looking in the wrong spots for these things. We're finding sites that are on land. You think about it, any civilized culture that like tries to like make a foothold anywhere else in the world, they all center around water. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They're always on the coast. That's where everything starts. No one starts in the middle of fucking nowhere with no water anywhere. You know what I mean? They all start on the edge of the fucking...
near a river or near a creek or whatever, yeah.
Exactly, because water's fucking vital to life. They need that water. They need easy access to it. So most places pop up in the water. Now, if the water level's raised fucking 400 feet in a day, like they say with the ice age and all the things melting, then we're looking in the wrong fucking spots for this stuff. It's out in the ocean.
Yeah, that makes
sense. But a lot of archaeological digs and stuff get pigeon-toed by governments and stuff. They don't let them do a lot of stuff in the oceans. They don't let them drill and do all sorts of crap in the oceans. They let them dig out in the middle of nowhere, but they don't let them do a lot of stuff in the ocean. So if something happened, like the floods and that raced through, like they said, the creating of the Grand Canyon was when a big flood came through and carved out the fucking canyon. Yep. Well, like that would take everything with it. Like, look at New Orleans when the flood came through; every fucking house and everything was
vehicle,
going with that.
If a vehicle's gonna fly down the road, surely a screwdriver or a fucking
everything,
trowel or
everything,
gonna be gone. Yeah, exactly. That makes a lot of sense. So
back in the day, the displacement of the Earth's crust and stuff, and the way we were all one continent like a long time ago, and it all kind of split off.
Yeah,
like you know, South America can kind of fit into Africa there, and you can kind of put it all together.
Yeah.
Well, they're talking about how do these cultures like the Inca and the Egyptians and stuff all have this same sort of architectural technology?
Yeah.
And like how do they all basically do the same thing, but yet they're miles apart? Well, if it was millions and millions of years ago, then the planets were connected, because now there's evidence that people were around when the dinosaurs were around.
Yeah.
So that we lived at the same time. So if it was millions of years ago, so like we've been here a hell of a lot longer than a lot of people like speculate we've been here for, because this is all speculation based on evidence that we're just finding, right?
Yeah, based on like
bio. They still find new shit, you know what I mean? And even sometimes when new shit is found, they discredit it because it just doesn't agree with what they've already found.
So it's really
What's
it's a lot up to personal opinion, realistically. It's up to the archaeologist's personal
Well, it
opinion
only makes sense
as
that
to
we've
what
been
they
around
say.
here for fucking way longer than they're saying because of the way this shit goes. As you dig down deeper, it gets bigger and more complex. And as it goes up, it sort of disappears. And like all those cultures just disappear.
Because
Just all of a sudden, they're just gone. The Egyptians, the Mayans, the
so
Inca,
the
like
theory you're
they're all
talking
just
about,
gone.
so the theory you're talking about is we basically were like, oh shit, there's gonna be a catastrophic world event. We're gonna go, and we went to fucking space or wherever we went, and then once the catastrophic event was done, sort of like Wall-E, but like that was
We're the
rubbish.
survivors of what was left behind.
And that's why everyone's so closely related. But
Yeah.
then how do you explain, like, I guess, do you reckon there's still people floating around out there somewhere? And theoretically,
Well,
if
water destroys everything over time. Like, it destroys absolutely everything. You know what I mean? Like,
I mean,
if there's bones and stuff in the ocean, like, they're gone. You know what I'm saying?
oxygen does as well, by all means.
Yeah, well, fossilized stuff like it isn't normal to have things fossilized. Like you bury something in your backyard, that like your dog in the backyard, that's just not gonna fossilize. You know what I mean? That happens in a very rapid succession of events, like very rapid death
It's
and very rapid
usually like
encapsulation.
lava. Usually like lava or ice would be fossilized
Lava
somehow.
or ice or something like that would, yeah, or maybe ice and then lava or who knows, but it happens like very fast. It's the only way that happens. Else everything just goes back to dust.
True.
So, like, what I'm saying is either something like that happened because if you notice, like, but then again, these cultures were probably all licking toads and eating fucking mushrooms and shit. You know what I mean? So, you can't really take what they're doing and what their artwork is. Like, if you take what our artwork of this culture with Pepe the Frog and the memes and shit, you take that 400 years into the future and show people that was our culture, like, we look fucked.
Oh my
You
God,
know what I
what's
mean? Like,
going
it's the
on with
same thing
those
with the
guys?
Mayans and stuff. Like, I believe a lot of it's artwork and, artistic licensing on some things,
For sure.
possibly like the Egyptians with the bird heads and the dog heads on people. Either there was another
Well,
race where there were bird heads and dog headed people,
those were
fucking aliens
supposedly
that came down and
gods.
whatever,
They
or
were.
it's just a representation, right? Just like we do.
Those were
But like
supposedly gods, though, weren't they? Like Anubis and Ra. They were supposedly their deities.
there were other beings that they always depicted this other like bird headed beings with these wings and stuff.
Birdman.
And I don't know, it was really fucking weird shit.
Birdman from Rick and Morty.
Yeah.
Crazy
But dude,
shit.
like, okay, like, look, here's a picture of the architecture I'll show you.
Is it like the comparison between the Mayan architecture and the pyramids? I think
Well,
I
the
have seen those
Mayan, like
pictures.
the Inca and the Aztecs and like all those places, they
They're
all sort of
always
have the same fucking thing.
big fucking stone steps, basically.
Huge stones. Like we're not talking like tiny fucking stones here. We're talking like monolithic structures, like fucking gigantic. Like, look, can you see that?
Jesus Christ, what's that, Aztec, is it?
That's where's that?
Or is it different?
That
It looks
is.
almost tribe. It looks a little bit more native than.
That's Inca. That's in South America, I think. Yeah. That's in South America. So if you see the big stones on the bottom there,
Wait, have you seen the thing about the big
are you
runway?
looking though? Look, look, look,
Yeah, no,
look.
I can see. I can
See the
see.
big stones, and then they get bigger and smaller, and then they get smaller as they get up. So as you're going up, you're going to newer. As you go down, you're going older.
Those are
Those
huge.
are there's no mortar or anything in between these rocks. They just fit fucking perfectly.
That's insane, eh? And
That doesn't make any
you
sense.
wouldn't be able to do it with a chisel.
No, because that's what they're
No.
saying. They're saying that was our technological fucking ceiling at that point, was a fucking iron or whatever, copper chisel or a fucking rock. That's impossible.
There's no way. There is
That is
absolutely no
fucking
way. And
impossible.
how are they lifting that shit up, man? Like,
Exactly.
this is like
Like, and the
you
thing
gotta like
is like
bulldoze
most
it.
quarries would be right next to the area where these rocks would be. These quarries are miles away. Like, they went out of their way to find specific types of rocks. So they knew something about the rock, the ground. You know what I mean? They went out of their way to find specific fucking rocks for specific places. And they would be fucking far away. There's sandstone in a place where sandstone's not even on that continent.
Jesus Christ.
So another theory could be, and I haven't heard this one anywhere, but we've been around for so fucking long that these structures are here from when we were all in that one continent, that Gondwana, one mega...
Gondwana land.
Is that what it's called?
Yeah, it's called Gondwana land, yeah.
Gondwana land?
God, W-A-N-N-A, land. Gondwana land. No, not to it, not two ends, just one end. Hang on, I'll send you through the Wikipedia link. Oh god, where's my fucking... There it is. That's the Wikipedia link for it anyway. And that's supposedly when all the continents were together in one. Look at this now. It says something about Laurasia.
Yeah, so that's Russia, Europe, and Asia. So you see where this is? So you see how it's all one thing? I don't know if you can bring that up on the screen for a second.
Oh god, I gotta find one that's... Yeah, here it is.
Dude, we should be doing conspiracy theories. Let's get into this shit.
We could do conspiracy theories, why the fuck not?
But anyways, yeah, we were supposed to talk about Christmas being on for 44 minutes now about this shit, so...
Christmas is... That was a dead topic really quickly. It was pretty shit for both of us. Kids loved it though. Why not? Where the fuck did I just save that to? It's in here somewhere. There it is.
Oh, it's getting hot in here.
Oh, I put that up on screen, but it's really tiny. Boom. There we go. That's what it's meant to be. Gondwana lands, South America, Africa, Antarctica. Antarctica's in there, okay. So that was before, I guess, before it was like at the south of the most southern point of the world.
With yeah, ice. Because we've turned also, like, mildly.
The axis of the world has turned, yeah.
Yeah, slightly.
And so that all drifted apart.
Here's another theory. Look. If we left, so like we knew something was going to happen because of previous times with I think, who built the ark? Is that Moses?
Noah,
Moses, what the fuck?
Moses split the red, did the Dead Sea or the Red Sea or some shit with the Egyptians?
Split the
Dead
Sea.
Yeah, he parted the sea.
Part my ass cheeks. Anyways. I can't find my lighter.
Speaking of,
what could be happening is like when we were all one continent like that, we either got to a certain technological point, because they're finding molds and shit now too. Like what you would use to like it's built in the rock, but it's like iron. Like you put the steel in there, and it would
like smelting
make the shape of whatever's in there. So we obviously had that technology. I think they're just underestimating the amount of technology, the technical level we actually got to back at that point.
And then there was
because I think with the stories that went on with the they must have known something happens.
Yeah.
So they left. You know what I mean?
For sure. They left.
It sounds fucking insane. Or we're really underestimating our technological level. And when the water did rise and shit did change and shit shifted, because when a plate shifts, that causes a fucking tidal wave. You know what I mean? Hundreds of feet tall.
And massive, like
massive
earthquake as well.
Massive. Yeah, and that would just take shit right out. Like things would just disappear. And that could be the other thing that happened. We literally just, everything got washed away in water, and it's all out in the middle of the fucking ocean where we can't really
and millions and millions, millions and millions of years, it's biodegraded to nothing, so there's no evidence of it anyway. Or some of the darkest parts of the ocean. So,
that could be that could be the other reason. Everything just got washed the fuck away into the sea, and it's out there, but it's gone.
But I mean, there's also the argument that we've only explored what 2% of the fucking world's oceans, and the world is
it's impossible.
The world's like 70% water as well. So I don't think we're gonna find anything in our age anyway. Not until they have some massive.
Not until
scanning.
They get to the bottom of like Mariana's Trench and all that stuff. But then, things down at that pressure level. The water is just crushing everything. You know what I mean?
So anything
it just crushes it to dust. Mm. So like any of those places that where we first like settled, like on the shores of anywhere, like Florida or like New Orleans, places that are prone to flooding, Yeah. There's definitely been some change in the way the world is because of these floods.
Oh, for sure. Like, yeah.
If you look at the last floods in New Orleans and Florida, and you look at the way the landmass changed just on those floods, just if there were bigger ones before, we have lost entire fucking parts of our history because of it.
Yeah, absolutely. Huge parts.
And like, we definitely have.
They're going to be in the one place that we're not able to look fully. I mean, basically, we're going to get to the point where they're going to just have a massive scanner and a fucking satellite just scan, and they can find shit like that. But
they already have all that shit. Like, it's getting there, but like, it's to the point where like the ocean water at that depth, if it's been drug out there for millions, like, it is gone. Do you know what I mean? It's gone.
Yeah, for sure.
Like, there's nothing to find down there. It's all just crushed up and shit.
Well and truly fucked.
Anyways, that was my tangent about how creation and being.
No, it's a good theory. My theory on that is that we actually went back and we're like in the middle, and then at some point in the future we get so technologically advanced that we create time travel, and we're like, wow, that's how all of these old civilizations got all the technology that they needed to build their empires. So we have to do that. So we're like finishing the loop, basically. Like, we have to go back in time to help ourselves so that we can get to this point where we can do time travel and shit like that. Otherwise, we're just going and fucking beating.
Maybe it wasn't us. Maybe we created AI finally.
Maybe
it went back.
Maybe.
And that, fucking.
Yeah, absolutely.
That makes more sense. If you look at human beings from an outside perspective onto Earth, like we're all going towards like a thing. Like, we're building something. Do you know what I mean? Like, we're all building some sort of something or other. Like we're always doing something, but we're not focused.
Are we? There's always the argument that we're not doing anything and that we're just fucking viruses. We're like a giant virus.
Well, if you want to base it on, like, if you look at the planet and you look at where humans are, we look like cancer.
Yeah,
we don't look healthy. It doesn't look good.
The world is cancer.
It's gray, and there's fucking, it's not a good look.
No one catches cancer because cancer can't catch itself.
Yeah, so like, if you were thinking like if there was superior beings in outer space flying by our planet, looking down, going, "What the fuck is that?"
Yeah,
like, you know what I mean?
Way.
Like,
look at
all this lush stuff, and they're just ignoring it. It's like we're taking all the resources from the planet, right? Like the oils and the trees and the water. We're using it all, and we're building all this computer shit. Why are we doing that?
Yeah,
it's like what the fuck is going on? Why are they building this shit? Like, what are they doing down there?
Can you imagine going back to living off the land, though? Can you imagine having to go out to the cow and milking the cow?
Oh, we couldn't fucking survive anymore.
No way.
We couldn't fucking survive.
Yeah, I mean, lazy.
People wouldn't know what to do with themselves.
They're like, what? I have to go and milk the cow? I can't sit here and watch TV in the mornings? Fuck that. I'll just kill myself. I reckon the suicide.
But that's the other thing too. People are hardwired to do something.
They are.
And now we just sit around all the time,
and we do nothing
with all these fucking 5-minute YouTube videos, just like changing camera angles every 5 minutes.
When the TV first came out, everyone said that it was a terrible invention. No one's gonna have time to watch the TV. Who's gonna have time to watch TV? You've got to do the laundry. You've got to fucking mop the floors and go and get the milk from the cow and go and get the eggs from the chicken and go and tend to your crop and shit like that. TV was like, what? Why do we need TVs? We've got no time to do anything for ourselves anyway. We have to do everything to keep ourselves alive. And then the washing machine came out, and then it was like, oh my god, the washing machine. So we just have to put the shit in there and then leave it for half an hour to an hour. What do I do? Well, let's have, oh, well, I can watch the TV now. I don't have to do any, oh, what, dishwasher? I'm just gonna put all the dishes in it, and then it washes them for me, and it takes an hour. What do I do while it's doing that? Oh, well, I guess I watch TV. And that's there. All of that shit that came out, that's where the world's gone wrong, I reckon. Because that's all costing more resources.
But all this stuff is all about our consumption again, right?
Like,
we for some reason believe that we're better than everything else.
Yeah, for sure.
You know what I mean?
Yeah,
because we fucking do this and that. Like, dolphins are fucking smart.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Well, have you seen the hitchhikers?
Dolphins are fucking brilliant animals. Just in their world, they don't need fucking tablets and TV and cell phones. And you know what I mean?
Have you seen Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, where the dolphins and the mice are like the smartest fucking creatures on the planet?
No.
And the humans are just not smart. It's because we don't speak telepathically. We're not as smart as them. As they can speak telepathically, supposedly. It's a good movie. Good watch.
I think I might have seen it. I don't remember though.
And the meaning of creation and life and all things. Do you know what the answer is?
What's that?
The meaning of life and creation and the meaning of everything is 42. they spent like millions of years building this computer, and then they had to wait another fucking trillion years or some shit for the answer. And it's like, well, I've been doing some thinking, and I think I've come up with an answer, but you're not going to like it. And they're like, what is the answer? Oh, great one. And it's like this big AI computer thing. And it's like, well, the answer to life and the meaning of all things is 42. And everyone's like, what? And they all go nuts. It's such a good watch. Really good watch. A really long movie, actually. Movies are getting ridiculously long these days. Speaking of movies.
Here's the thing, though. Have you watched like an hour and a half movie? Like a 90-minute runtime movie lately?
No, actually, I haven't.
They suck dick.
They're really short. The
plot, they are so bad.
There's not enough time in them to put everything together into a proper story, right? That's what I'm getting from it anyway.
Exactly. This is the exact fucking structure of it. The first 22 minutes to half an hour set up every individual story of the characters you do not give a fuck about.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
You don't care about their little intricate backstories because, you know, like cut in halfway between them ending a joke. You know they're like charming and hilarious. You know what I mean?
If you want to do a 90-minute movie, you may as well just make a small TV series. You may as well do like fucking five of them and get it over and done with. Make it, instead of making one 90-minute movie, make 10 40-minute movies.
Here's the perfect example. It. The new It. The remake.
Yeah.
The first It. How fucking long was that one?
I have no idea.
The old one. When was the old one? 1988? 1990.
193
minutes.
What's that? 2.5 hours? 2 hours? Just over 2 hours?
Yeah. Now, when the remake, they made it part one, a part two.
Oh, is this meant to be part two?
No, they made it part one. Like, they split that 2.5 hour right. story in It. To a 2 minute, 2 hour 15 part one with the remake.
Yeah.
So like they never went back as adults. I don't know if you ever seen it. They go back as adults to whatever the fuck.
Never. I'm not.
Watching the movie, I was like, aren't they adults in the original one?
Oh right.
And I realized that they defeated him when they were children. They went back as adults to do it again, and that's when he turned into a giant spider. An alien or some shit.
So did they not do that in the new one, or they did it all in one 2.5 hour movie?
They did it part two. I just said this. They're doing it in two parts, the new one.
Oh, okay. So that's the bonus. So they're doing it in two hour parts, yeah. Or do they?
Yeah, because like if that was a 1 hour and an hour and a half movie by itself, that would have been fucking terrible. Absolutely fucking terrible.
But because
the thing with that movie, it happens
because they're doing the part two.
The demon, the clown is like a demon that eats kids or whatever.
Yeah.
And each one of them, it builds on, like, his power is based off their fear. So it knows what they're afraid of. So it scares them. And as it scares them, it gets more power and get closer to them.
Oh, okay. So it feeds off of fear.
Yeah. And in it, each kid has like a very specific. So fear or whatever, and it goes into each one of their stories. You don't really notice it as you're watching it, but individually it's showing you each one's problem.
So it's basically the Green Lantern, but with a clown and no Green Lantern. I'm sorry, I just basically, like, because it's like they're feeding off the fear, and that's what the bad guy in Green Lantern does. He, like, feeds off.
He's not Green Lantern.
He feeds off of fear, and it was a terrible movie, so that sort of fits. Green Lantern was
which one, the Ryan Reynolds?
That was the downfall.
The Ryan Reynolds one?
Yeah, the Ryan Reynolds. That was a downfall of Ryan Reynolds and superhero movies for me, but he kind of did bring it back with Deadpool. He's done a really, he was like born for that part, really.
Then he pushed to have it like done?
Yeah, he was actually the one who set the whole movie up from what I've read and watched. He was sort of like, hey, this is the kind of the character that I've based my whole acting career off of. Can we make a movie now that you guys are finally doing fucking Marvel and DC movies? Can we make a movie and do it? And they're like, yeah, and we'll throw two X-Men in there too. And he's like, why can't we do all the X-Men? And they're like, it's going to be expensive. And then it hit like one of the, there's like one of the biggest grossing Marvel movies of all time. I'm like, oh shit, maybe we should have put some more X-Men in there.
Who would they put in there? Meg, Teenage Megasonic Warhead?
Yeah, have you seen the photos of her without bald head? She's
No.
actually stunning, but she just like dresses up to look like a badass in that movie, where she's not really. Sorry, I should speak in my native tongue. She looks like a bad ass in that movie, a bad ass. That's how Kiwis say things.
Badass.
I should speak in full Kiwi accent instead, or try to. I don't know. I got this weird thing where if I'm talking to someone with an accent, I slowly, I very, actually don't slowly, I very immediately take on that accent and start using it. It's
That's
funny as hell.
racist.
It is really ra it's really, really racist when you go in to
Oh, look at my hair.
a fish and chip shop. Oh my God. So you're Napoleon Dynamite's dad. It's actually really racist when you go into like a Chinese like fish and chip shop and
Oh, I'm sure you do.
you say, "Hey, can I have a piece of fish? How much is a piece of fish?" And they go, "Oh, that's $2." And you're like, "Oh, $2." They're like, "Yeah, $2." And I'm, "Oh, okay, $2. Can I have $2 chip, $2 fish?" And they're like sitting there going, "Are you taking the piss out of me or what? Like, what's going on here?" Like, no, I'm sorry, it's a problem I have.
Being racist is a problem you have.
Being racist, it's a, I don't know what,
Or
it's a
racially offensive.
psychological thing, eh? It's like, because if I feel like if I went to Australia, I would pick up the Australian accent so fast, like within a week I'd be like a good old Aussie bloke, eh? The chuck another
I think
shrimp.
Canadians are hindered with the A thing when Australians say it all the time.
Hey mate, yeah, that's a good. It's the way Canadians say it, eh?
How do I say it? Have I even said it?
I don't think you'd know. That's actually something you don't actually say a much. You say it
I guess
like,
I'm asking a question that I'm expecting like a response to.
yes, that's when you do it. That's when you do something.
That's
Yeah,
when I say it.
that's yeah. Whereas
I'm
we do
like
it.
blah 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 blah.
Whereas Australians and Kiwis do it as like a confirmation. Like that's really expensive, eh?
Yeah.
That's really expensive, eh?
Yeah. I do it as
Whereas,
like a question where I'm expecting an answer. If it's just
yeah.
like a rhetorical question, I don't say it. But if it's like, hey, like fucking pay attention to me. Don't want to butt in here, but hey.
you probably do say a quite a bit. I just don't pay attention or notice it at all.
I don't even notice if I've done it. We've been talking for like an hour now. We should probably cut this episode anyways.
Oh yeah, no, we can probably cut this episode.